Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School is dedicated to the formation of tomorrow's leaders through a Roman Catholic experience that provides excellence in atmosphere, academics, the arts, and athletics. Our vision is to be one of the most innovative, influential, and accomplished Roman Catholic schools in the nation.
Good morning, Mavericks. My name is Emily Avila. Please stand for our prayer and Pledge of Allegiance. Today is February 4th, Monday of the fourth week in Ordinary Time. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord our God, help us who have listened in the name of Jesus Christ and heard the good tidings. Help us come with our whole hearts to the Savior, who leads us into your arms. Hear our pleading and let your countenance shine over the world. Let a new age come soon. Send your salvation into the world to the glory of your name, so that the truth we have learned about you becomes a reality in our hearts and in our whole life, can be genuine, rooted in the truth, leading us into heaven. To honor of your name, hear us, O Lord, we entrust ourselves and our daily lives to you. We want to be faithful. Help us to be your children, mindful every step that we belong to you. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Please turn to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Have a great day, Mavericks.
Mars in the tower beats on the track.
Good morning, Mavericks. I'm Bruce Demouse.
And I'm Audrey Paternoster. Let's get into right into today's announcements.
First, we want to say thank you, Mavericks, for showing your school spirit at our pep rally on Friday. It was a great time and a perfect show of school spirit for all of our teams heading into their district competitions.
And it was an amazing turnout on Saturday at the Walk for the Animals 2019. I've never seen so many cute dogs in one place. It was a really great time. Thank you to everyone who donated items, walked, or even just showed up with your cute pets. The baby goats were my absolute favorite. They were totally adorable. A special thanks to Ms. Calder and all the Paws for a Cause members that did an outstanding job raising funds for a wonderful cause.
With Mav games right around the corner, there's still time to sign up for your games, but don't hesitate. The extension will only be until tomorrow at lunchtime. If you've already paid but haven't signed up for your games, be sure to do that today. If you have any questions, please email Mrs. Lovett.
The Booster Club will be selling merchandise on Wednesday, February 6th, and they are also looking for volunteers for concession sales. Any volunteers interested can please email boosterclub@mccarthyhigh.org. The next Booster Board meeting will be on Tuesday, February 12th at 7 p.m. in the iLounge.
Save the date, Mavericks. The Sandlot Movie Night and Carnival is back. Friday, March 15th from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. on the practice field. A giant inflatable movie screen, lots of baseball fan favorite foods, and various club and team game booths are available, as well as raffle prizes. Tickets are $5 and include two booth tickets and will be sold at all lunches March 11th to 14th. Contact Mrs. Curtis with any questions. That is definitely going to be a fun event for a great cause. Now, let's move on to world news. Yesterday was the sporting event of the year, as Super Bowl 53 aired to nationwide to hardcore fans, casual viewers, and people who watched just for the commercials. Maroon 5, Travis Scott, and Big Boy were the performers at the halftime show, along with a surprise appearance from none other than Squidward and the iconic Band Geeks from SpongeBob SquarePants. We'll talk more about the game itself in tomorrow's Mav Sports Zone.
This Sunday, feathers are flying across Oxfordshire, England, as a Rhea named after Chris Rhea, the singer, made its escape through town. The Rhea is a South American relative of the ostrich and emu, but this one was most likely owned by a small local farm. We have no updates whether or not the bird has been captured yet. Apparently, the big bird gave authorities a run for their money and a little extra excitement for the town.
Last week, we informed you about Groundhog's Day, and the results are in. Winter is over, at least according to the cute forecasting furball. The groundhog did not see his shadow, leading many to celebrate the end of this frigid winter. But don't get your hopes up. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, Punxsutawney Phil's only been correct 40% of the time. So we recommend holding off on swimming for just a bit. And with that, let's check out the rest of this week's announcements. We're going to hold off on that for a bit.
And for lunch, we'll be having chicken noodle soup, chicken Alfredo, fettuccine with butter, Parmesan breadstick, cheese croquette, and peas and carrots.
God, now I'm hungry for some of those breadsticks.
Always hungry.
Well, that's all for today's edition of Mav News. I'm Bruce Demos.
And I'm Audra Paternoster. Have a marvelous Monday, Mavs.
I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one, and I've been quiet for too long. I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one, and I've been silent for too long. Savior, but I'm not asking for favors.